If you look at the underside of the Boeing 737 shortly after takeoff or in flight, you'll see that the main landing gear wheels sit exposed after folding into their housing. On most other aircraft, it's covered by closing doors. This has been the case since the first 737 was introduced. But why is this? This is related to a design issue that dates back to the first 737-100, which was introduced in 1968. The aircraft was designed to be low to the ground, a choice to make the 737 more usable at smaller regional or remote airports, which were unlikely to have air bridge facilities or baggage loading systems. Keeping the aircraft lower to the ground would make it much easier to load passengers and cargo, and also to service and fuel the aircraft with limited equipment. This was a key market that Boeing wanted to capture with the 737, so the trade-offs of a lower fuselage were worth it. Later, Boeing went further with modifications to land on gravel runways in remote regions. With the fuselage kept lower to the ground, there was no room for landing gear doors. These require extra clearance and could come into contact with the ground. Removing the doors, though, was not necessarily a bad thing. It's one less mechanical item to be repaired and maintained, and it reduced the overall weight of the aircraft and freed up vital space in the belly of the aircraft. With the wheels exposed, though, some other changes were needed. The wheels have smooth hubcaps on the external facing side, which aids aircraft aerodynamics. There's also a rubber seal around the fuselage opening. This helps prevent any objects or water entering the landing gear enclosure. The landing gear was not the only area of the 737 that needed alterations for a lower fuselage. The engine housings on many of the engines used on the 737 are flat, as opposed to perfectly circular as on most other aircraft. This again dates back to the original low-to-the-ground design of the aircraft, which was different from many of the competing aircraft at the time, where engines were tail-mounted. Boeing considered this for the 737 but preferred wing mounting to increase the fuselage width and make the engines more accessible for maintenance. Bigger engines came quickly, though, to accommodate larger turbines and fans and offer higher bypass ratios. These would not fit in the limited underwing space of the 737, and the solution was to flatten the bottom of the engine housing. The design soon became known as the hamster pouch design. The 737 is alone amongst the main Boeing and Airbus aircraft for this wheel storage. But if you take a look at the Embraer ERJ-145 and the Embraer E-Jet aircraft, you'll see the same system. The Chinese-built Comac ARJ-21 also has the same, while the main landing gear of the A220 are also uncovered. Have you noticed the landing gear on the 737 on any other aircraft type? Let us know in the comments. Did you know that we publish over 175 stories every single week on simpleflying.com? Be sure to check the link in the description for more great stories just like this. Thanks for watching, and be sure to like and subscribe before you go.